Hi, everyone. My name's Ryan Kavanaugh. Thank you for having us here. I think the room's a little small. Anyway, I'm going to talk very fast because my partner Bobby here is going to do most of the talking today about social streaming, which is something you've probably never heard of. But for a moment, I'm just going to give a little bit of backdrop as to why social streaming is an important topic to talk about. So our history is for the past 15 years, we've been very prominent in media. We started a studio in 2003, and we built it to be the largest mini-major studio. By 2014, we were bigger than Lionsgate or DreamWorks. We were putting out 30 movies a year, 40 television shows. We had built the second largest sports agency, and we had one of the biggest digital footprints. All those businesses we sold at different stages of their iteration. So we started Proxima Media about two and a half years ago on the premise that media is all converging. So in 2010, we made the very first deal with Netflix. And the press in Los Angeles had a field day writing about how could we make this a deal with this crazy little DVD company called Netflix. Why would we not make a deal with HBO? And I sat at the Milken Conference in 2011 and did the keynote at CES in 2012. And same thing. Tried to sat there and argued with the heads of pretty much every studio that the world wanted what they wanted. They wanted to watch it how they wanted to watch it, and Netflix was going to own it. And the studios, of course, discounted it and said, yep, it's not going to happen. So now we hear about the streaming wars every single day. Disney has launched Disney Plus, AT&T obviously bought Warner Brothers, you obviously have Netflix and Amazon competing, you have Hulu, you have Roku. Every single day we hear about another person joining the streaming war. But for us, when we look at media, and within the Proxima media infrastructure, we have film and we have IP and we have television and we have technology. But when we look at media, once again, we think that the giants, as we want to call them, the Disneys of the world, the Warners of the world, who are all now trying to catch up to, obviously, Netflix and maybe somewhat Amazon, are actually catching up to the past, not the future. Because right now, what they're trying to do is own long-form content, once again, by launching streaming services that allow consumers to sit generally at home or on a pad and watch an hour-long episode or two-hour-long episode, as we just saw with Apple TV, launching five movies that are all, you know, 2 hours and multiple five or six episodic series, nothing short form. But what we're here to tell you is that, like in 2010 and 11, when we created what we called subscription video on demand, and the studio said we were crazy, we actually feel like the studios who are now trying to catch up to streaming video on demand are, again, looking in the past, not the future. Because the future is that there is only one type of content. Content is content. And consumers today, they want to view it in one format. They don't want to go watch long form on their TV and short form on their phone and a tidbit on YouTube on their computer. They want everything to be in one place. And for some reason, where our industry has fractured and always fractured this media component where this is long form, this is movies, this is short form, this is TV. So the thing that we found, and one of the things we did at Relativity is we built the second largest studio's music library, which we sold to Sony, is we found that music was sticky. And one thing we also found is that across social media and across media, music was key. If you try to watch a movie with no music, I promise you, no matter how good, you'd hate it. If you tried to watch a TV show with no music, you would hate it. So what we've done, one of the pieces of Proxima Media, is that we've been building an app called Triller, which is now the fastest growing social sharing music app. And we coined the term social streaming. And the reason is that we recognize consumers want a platform where they can watch what they want to watch, when they want to watch it, and how they want to watch it. And not only do they want to watch, they want to interact with it. So Triller is that place where we look at the future where all entertainment we think is going, which is that all pieces, long form, short form, interacting, sending video, making video, is all in one place, all in one home. And we think that our numbers to date have proven it, being now we'll exceed TikTok in the US this month. So with on the background of media. Sorry for a little bit of a media speech, but I'm going to turn it over to my partner, Bobby, who actually runs Triller, and he'll talk a little bit about what Triller has done and how we're changing the world of media.
All right, thanks, Ryan. So if you look at conversion in the video game industry from freemium to premium, it's about 5%, maybe 6%, 9% on the really high side. If you look at, for example, streaming conversion, for example, Spotify's last quarterly meeting, they are converting from freemium to premium at a rate of about 50%. If you extrapolate that to the amount of users that they have, it is by far the stickiest medium. And so at Triller, what we've created is a partnership in the music system that has an ecosystem where everyone coexists, the artist, the label. So every time a Triller video is made, the artist gets a stream count, and that counts for platinum records. We recently did a project with The Weeknd, who's a big American artist. had the number one and the number two song globally because Triller generated 30 to 40 million on-network views, which translates to about 2 billion off-network views. So 2 billion off-network views translates to about 500 million streams, which is, you know, we're running out of room in the office for platinum records. So it's changing the way that music discovery is, and it's changing the way that people find music and play with music. When you use music interactively, the chances of you sharing it increase 800%. Those are metrics that the music industry has done a lot on. What I'd like to do is actually just show you kind of how we've gamified Triller. So I have a video that we'd like to show. It's a lot
easier. What's up, guys? Welcome to Triller, the social network and video editor all in one app. I'm Montana Tucker, and today I'm gonna show you guys all the cool new features. You ready? So for those wondering what Triller is, well, it's a high quality video creation tool and social entertainment platform in one. It's the simplest way to create flawless videos, shoot beautiful films, and collaborate with friends. You use all of your favorite music from all of the top and upcoming artists with none of the copyright infringements. You can make a short film, add amazing filters, and sit back and watch your videos come to life with our AI powered editing. Once you are finished making your next viral video, you can upload it to your Triller profile on any third-party app like Instagram, Facebook, or Twitter. With Triller's new social network, you can discover others who are also using the app to make their favorite content. With unique challenges from your favorite artists, exclusive content, music, and miniseries, Triller is a place to see and be seen. There are curated channels for you to explore, everything from dancing, fitness, lifestyle, and many more. Triller empowers its creators so your number of followers doesn't affect how many people you can share your content with. When you do get those views up, you can fight your way to the top spots on our leaderboards. Triller will also be helping you get those dollars up as well. Soon, you will be able to earn money from all of your amazing content. So, I want to see all of you amazing creators out there being yourself and showing the world what you're made of.
So, I mean, that's how Triller's gamifying the music discovery process. It's very similar to TikTok in the sense that the AIs kind of work the same. It's biometric movement, which engages with the audience. But the difference is that when, you know, the ticker passes 31 seconds, the artist generates revenue. And so that's because we have licensing agreements with the largest labels, and they're actually equity holders. So what happens is now, Triller is becoming a go-to deployment for artists, because why would you not utilize Triller to deliver your message? So recently we did a deal with Apple, and we're doing one with Spotify as we speak, that allows people that have Apple Music or Spotify or Deezer or Tidal to be able to use their credentials to actually stream through the player. And what that does is, actually, I have a video for that too.
Yeah. She gon' let me smash cause she love rapper wolves. Pump, then I dump. Blix in a trunk.
Chase the money.
I look good. Ooh, I'ma run that sack up to the ceiling like I should. I got 2 for 5 apple.
What you're seeing is a fan interacting with the song, sharing it out to his socials, and the artist actually seeing the engagement and actually participating and sharing as well. The key in music is there's a lot of good artists out there and there's a lot of good songs, but if nobody hears it, it doesn't matter. It doesn't exist. And what Triller has become is a premier music discovery mechanism for artists. Another thing that is developing is, as we create more AI tools, we've created ways to basically create music videos and to be able to remix songs and to actually give the user the ability to create their own version of the songs. So traditionally, if you want to produce a song, you have to have some kind of digital audio workstation like an Ableton, and you need access to the beats of the song, parts of the song. We call them stems.
For those that aren't technical, basically it's $100,000 and someone to operate a machine and a long time before us.
Yeah. So what we've created is basically stemless abilities for people to create content that they're more emotionally attached to. So if I hear a song, I don't have to attach that to my socials the way it's designed. I can remix it on my own. In fact, I have a demo to show you, because this is where we have 9 patents around this. So this is actually a test flight that was created to hold my mic up. So it has the same kind of look and feel, but what you'll see here is kind of how the AI works. It kind of shows you like behind the scenes. And so there's 2 modes. In the automatic mode, we'll pick a track or any kind of music asset. And then instead of using the camera or the filters, we're just going to, for the demo purpose, we're going to go through our phone here, and we're going to pick, guy likes his dog, so we pick his dog. And so there's a little buffer down here that says, okay, 30 seconds, that's enough compression. So we're just gonna pick some of these, and we already picked a track. And then after the buffer kind of moves to the middle, it'll tell you, the AI will tell you that that's enough, you have enough content. And then you just hit next, and what you'll see is a fully quantized waveform, mixed and mastered with the video interlaced. And so what you've done here now is you've actually taken this track and you've put it to your music, and the AI, based on the beats and the movements, it's actually 1,000 data points, will flip the audio, the video.
One thing just I think that is very important to point out is, if you see the lines and the colors, actually the AI is literally stitching the song together. That's not a song straight. And everybody in the music business, the biggest labels, the biggest artists, when they see that, they cannot comprehend how the AI actually is able to take a song and it sounds so natural.
So in this mode, this is actually where all the music producers that we show this to go absolutely crazy. So we'll pick a track here, and it's kind of the same concept. You see the digital waveform of the track. Typically, what you have to do now on any social media platform, you take the track as is and you attach it to whatever video. But here we're going to make our own version. So let's say we want this part of the song. We hit plus. We take this part of the song. We hit plus. So what we're doing is actually we're taking this artist's track and we're chopping it. And the AI is building the song. So we have our own remix now. And it's the transitions are interlaced as if it was written for this track.
If we can turn it up a little bit.
You see the transition points? You see the next one? You can't tell that the song was cut and it wasn't done in a professional studio.
Can we turn it up again, please?
And then on this last stage, this is all about getting people to play with your musical asset or to play with your publishing or to add stuff to it. Because the more you use music, the more likely is you're to share it. Actually, 800 times more likely to share it. So remember the dog videos? This time we're going to select them all. And we play it like a drum pad. So we can tell our story. Just hold this down. And I populate it. And so, now we're actually completely interacting with it. And we're actually completely telling. So now I have a song that no one has because I made it myself. I'm telling my story the way I want. And the AI keeps you on the guardrails so you don't actually do something inadvertently. We can actually kill this video because you get the...
I think one thing that Bobby didn't point out is when you've seen these red boxes, this is actually an iPhone. This is actually a working iPhone, as you're listening to the music, picking the pictures you want to go over that music. So you're someone sitting on the iPhone listening to it and picking what they like and creating their own music video.
So there's a couple of other things that we've developed on top of the Apple AR kit, which is actually really interesting. And we showed this to Apple, and they were quite fascinated with how we were able to take the new iPhone camera and be able to map the human body. Can we play the second to last video, please? Sorry, I know they're gonna get mad that I do that out of sequence, but I don't come here that often.
Is this the one you want?
Yeah, so if you see, this is kind of the body mapping. And so this is what we've done using the new Apple camera, and it's built on Apple's AR kit. And so we have the mapping down to about 90 points. So it's a 3D map of your body. So you think to yourself, okay, big deal. What does this look like? Can you play the last video, please? And that's the last video we have. So what we're creating is a filter experience to where anyone can dance like anyone. So what's going to happen now is we can take your body, take a source subject, and make you absolutely follow the source subject. So this woman is no longer here. We've mapped her, and she's an AR version of herself, dancing like the source subject with the detection poses that we showed you.
And this is done using an iPhone.
So I always lie to people and say I can dance. I can dance now. And you can all dance. And so the reason we're showing you this is because imagine making your own song, being able to dance like your favorite artist, and being able to produce that content, and being able to share that content with the world. No one has anything like this. This is the next. So we're just going to go through a couple examples. The last two are my favorite. So
the first 10 seconds, she's there.
Yeah.
The rest of it, she's not there.
So, yeah. So what happens is when she goes like this, the AR kit is trying to map her body and identify to her which bits and pieces are her. And now she's dancing.
And when Bobby says AR kit, he means this iPhone right here. That's all that's been used.
Well, it's the Apple AR kit. Okay, you gotta stop now. Okay, go. So she's mapping now again, and then she's mapped. So she's no longer existent. And this is actually a source video that we mapped. So we also are able to take the phone and go to a live show and map someone dancing and create a false green screen and match my body movement to them. So imagine like an application like Bruce Lee. You can fight like Bruce Lee, or you can dance like this lady. We're pretty confident that these filters are gonna break the internet. Okay, so Bruno Mars. In fact, I think he's performing here next week. I saw a billboard. Now we have two people together. As soon as they're mapped, now they dance like Bruno Mars. And you can do this with your friends, obviously. And remember, this is a 23-point mapping. We have it up to 90 now. So we don't show the ones that we're releasing, obviously. This is the ones that are not. And this is just examples, Art. And last but not least, who likes ballet? They do. Okay, thank you. Yeah, I'm done. You got a minute. You want to say something?
Well, anyway, the point, I think, of what we're making here is obviously Triller, we think it's a very exciting app. We're the fastest growing, like I said, in social sharing and social music. But we think that it's a home for all content. And we think content today, the streaming wars are a little bit ridiculous because they're all fighting for long form. They're all fighting for your home screen. What we really believe is that what the consumer wants, particularly the younger consumer, is something where they can watch, share, interact, change, be part of, and publish. And that's what really we're doing at Proxima. We're taking all the assets we have, which includes ownership of Stan Lee. We've made 250 movies. We have a lot of IP, and we're dedicating it towards Triller, using the world of social media and using the world of social streaming to actually create what we really believe the consumer wants, not the social streaming wars between Disney and Amazon.
Thank you, everybody.